What about Red Auerbach? Yeah, I mean, because he's the architect.
Well, he loved Nelly. Okay. And at one point, he offered him the job.
Right.
And Nelly was so tight with Jim Fitzgerald that he didn't take the job. But we'd play him almost every year in the playoffs. Now, he wasn't beyond, in those days, pulling a few tricks. So we'd go to a shoot-around, and there'd be no basketballs. Or we'd go in the locker room, and it'd be the playoffs in the spring, so it'd still be cold out, but he'd have the windows open and the heat up to about 100 in the locker room.
Auerbach.
Yeah, okay. Or there'd be no hot water in the shower room.
Yeah.
Just subtle little things to get under your skin.
Right.
And Nelly really learned a lot from him. He admired him. It was quite a thing. When Nelly used to tell me that he'd go in early on purpose and go up in Red's office and just talk basketball with him. And I think that's where he gained a lot of his knowledge about the game. He was a great teacher and handled and coached the guys terrific, and just had a great sense for the game.
You roughly remember the time period when they wanted Nelly? Was it after Fitch and before Jones, Casey Jones? Or
well, Nelly played for Heinsohn.
Okay, sure.
And he played for Auerbach.
Right, right.
And okay. he didn't play for Fitch.
No, I'm not saying, but I was saying after when it was when Fitz.
All the stuff going on.
Well, exactly. The coach. I'm saying what time period did they want him to be the coach?
Was that after Bill that Fitch? Was the that would have been after Fitch.
Okay, after Fitch.
Yeah,
okay.
And.
So mid-80s or so.
Of course, I'm sitting there with, he said, hey, Saint, you think we ought to go back to Boston? And I'm like, well, you know, I'm being respectful. Well, coach, whatever you think is best, you know, and all that kind of, I'm like this, you know, praying that we're going back.
Yeah, right.
And who knows what would have happened.
Right, exactly. But what did happen, I would not be sitting in your kitchen, because you ended up out here. There was a, I know too much about you. First, you went to the Nets.
Yeah.
And talk about Weltman and Bob McKinnon.
Yeah.
People don't even know that. They were the brain trust of the Spirits of St. Louis. Tell people who that was.
Well, that was in the ABA.
Yeah.
And they had a guy named Marvin Barnes.
Exactly.
So his nickname was Bad News Barnes.
Providence.
So he went to Providence, a great player, with Ernie DeGregorio and Kevin Steakum. So one time during the playoffs, he misses the team flight. Nobody chartered a plane back then. He charters a flight. He comes walking into the locker room. He's got a fur coat on with his uniform underneath. And he looked at all the guys and he says, have no fear. Marvin's here.
Exactly.
And he went out and scored 55.
Right, right.
Now, that league was unbelievable.
Yeah.
Well, during those Nets days, I was with Buck Williams, Mike Jaminski, Michael Corrin, Phil Ford. We had some good players.
Yeah.
Dave Wohl was an assistant coach with me with Milwaukee, and he talked me into coming back there with him. We went for a couple years. My wife and I loved it.